Okay, this is the video that hundreds of you have been asking for. And this is the service dress, class A, class B, class Z, whatever it is that your military service calls it. I'm gonna go from soup to nuts here on this, okay? First thing is, let's talk about how you're gonna wash this. Two options. You have the dry cleaner and then you have you. Okay. So the dry cleaner is going to screw up your uniform unless they're like military people on base. They're gonna just like wreck your crap. And even the people on base, they don't care. Okay. So I have two sets of, or two categories of uniforms. I have four sets of everything. One of them is my executive uniform. So my last video, I have my executive OCP, my work OCP, which I iron in 3 minutes. All right. And then I have an executive, this one, executive blues in the Air Force service dress, which I always have long sleeve, don't care. Never wear short sleeve in my executive uniform. And then I have a couple, two short sleeve, kind of like I just make them look real nice. And I use those most of the time if it's like our service dress days that we have at work, which I hate. But if I got to go to Congress or, you're in trouble or you get an award, you have one uniform that you keep for those occasions and you only wear them on those occasions so you don't wear them out. And they're always ready. All right. I wash my own stuff and I iron my own stuff because dry cleaners are idiots, or can be. And they get a seam or a crease in there that is not lined up to a previous one. Your uniform is hosed. I will never risk that. Okay. So this is how you do it. Wash it first, always inside out, always buttoned up. All the way to the top. Even if it's the short sleeve, which you can leave without the button, you wash it like this, okay? Inside out, throw it in the wash. Do not use bleach. Do not wash it with the other crap. And especially don't wash it with your whites. Use baking soda as your detergent. If you want detergent, use the not dyed, all natural stuff. Purex will do it. It's very good. However, it's not a great disinfectant. Baking soda is a pretty good disinfectant, but it doesn't kill viruses, it kills wild bacteria. This will kill everything else. And this is a softener. I do not recommend using softeners on your uniforms because you're trying to make them crisp. You don't want them soft, but you can put a little bit in there if you still want like a more softer experience. Some people get kind of irritated, on the inside if it's stiff and agitating. So you can use that only. All right. Travel with one of these. Okay. This is like a, I forget what they're called, but it's a roller. Okay, lint roller. Get you one of these bags that has a little thing that you can hang up in your garment bag or in your closet right next to that thing. What I do is I have one hanger in the entire uniform. This is not it. I have one hanger that has little clips, but the entire uniform goes on. I clip the pants in there. All right. I bring the cuffs up. I clip them in there so it makes a loop. And then I put this attached to it like that. And the whole entire uniform sits there when I travel or when it's up there. When I need to go, I need to get ready. Hey, Ken, surprise award later this afternoon. Oh, crap. That's happened. Gotta go home and get my nice uniform. I need everything ready to go. I take this with me. Okay. And then right before the ceremony, get all that crap off there. Okay. Starch. First, if you want to be dope, make your own starch. Go on Google, look up make your own starch from potatoes. It's actually quite easy and it is awesome. It will make your uniform like you'll be walking around like this. I mean, it is amazing. Niagara is good. They have an original finish and then they have heavy and crisp. So get the crisp. It's really good. Just know that if you do it on this, lightly spread. You want to saturate it, but just be gentle. Don't like crush it, okay? And you always let it put it up and let it dry with a fan. Do not run this through the wash if you can stand it and you have the patience to iron an dryer top. It'd be very wrinkly. The faster you can get it out of the wash and hang it up, the less terrible it wrinkly it will be. But if you want the most killer uniform, do not put this thing in the dryer. Take it out and let it dry because the elements that are in the water, your natural water that's coming out of the sink, has a bunch of junk in it, calcium and whatever, lime and everything. You want all that in your uniform because if you wash this and you have pretty hard water when you put it out, you don't even need starch. Typically, water is really hard. Okay. All right. So let's talk about how to iron this baby. First, take off all the crap. You're going to do that anyway when you wash it, and you leave it as though you're going to wear it. Okay. Talk about the top first. First, this has a light coating of starch in it for me because I move around a lot, and this is not my like executive one. I will tell you about the executive one, but you will see kind of like my work one. All right. So first, this would be pretty stiff if this was your executive one and it has heavy starch and you didn't go let it go through the dryer. Okay. What you want to do is just be really careful. All right. And you just kind of want to examine it to kind of look at the condition of it. Use this time. I'm getting a little bit of browning here that I don't like. And a good recipe for that is baking soda and hydrogen peroxide. To put the baking soda in there, squirt the hydrogen peroxide on there, like 2% solution, work it with a cloth, and it'll get that black brown staining out of there pretty easily. Okay. Don't use the sprays. All right. Use a natural solution base. Also, if it's kind of stubborn, like I have this little thing right there, you can take vinegar from cleaning vinegar from the store, or you can take your handy dandy softener, mix it with the baking soda, and it has a reaction. That chemical reaction, when they touch each other, lifts up like anything and everything off of your uniform. It's a really good trick. And it doesn't like bleach. What you do want to do is like do that before you throw it in the wash, or if you like forget and you're like, oh my God, I did it, and look, I got this thing right there. Just do it really quick. Okay, get a face cloth from the bathroom, put the baking soda on there, put the vinegar, and then work it, and then take that face cloth, put water in it, dilute the solution, and you'll be good to go. And the iron will even dry it out too. So you put the iron right in there, and it'll dry it out. So. All right, so what I do, okay, is I iron with it buttoned up. I've had enough experience with this, and why I do this is everything gets ironed twice, and I love to make sure my creases, so when they sew these things, the act of sewing just kind of squishes it, and I don't like that. So when I'm ironing, when I have it as though I'm wearing it, I can get those seams and even put a little sort of professional crease in that seam. You want to get it right on that seam. I kind of so get it right on that seam, and it just gives this kind of like really crisp professional look to it. Okay, if this is your executive one, you don't want to go too much like back and forth. And what I do is I've gone through like 30 of these things because I bend them so you can put your thigh under there. Just push it down. And you'll see, it just makes it look really crisp and nice. All right, remember my OCP video? Okay. You really want to keep the optical illusion in mind. Lack of creases, but with things kind of out of place, will make your uniform look kind of weird. So I always make sure I work the seams and stretch the seams out. And I like giving this 3D kind of look to my uniform. So most people iron it down, but I iron under it to kind of lift the seam up, and it just gives this eye-catching kind of 3D look to it. And what I care about, why my uniform is nice, is people remember a sharp uniform. They don't remember it consciously, but they remember it unconsciously. They associate you with being crisp, clean, and squared away. Okay. So I want their brains to process as much awesomeness about me without me even speaking. Okay. And I come in here with this little kind of tip, and I just kind of go right under this. So I've glued those down. See this? I've glued those down. I never recommend having those not glued, but I kept the edges unglued. So I glued that down, but kept the edges up. So it still looks like I didn't sew them down. Their brain won't interpret that I sewed it down, because they'll be like, oh, this guy just sewed it down, you know. Oh no, it looks like it has this 3D effect, but wow, look how crisp and clean and squared away that is. It's the ultimate effect. Okay. So you see here, that looks pretty good. I mean, it looks actually really good for that side. So all you do is kind of repeat, and because you're visually challenged with the way I have my camera set up, I'm going to do it on this side too. So see that seam that's on the side there? You can also just do that. It'll stretch it out really nice, and you don't even have to iron, waste your time ironing. If you kind of you're like, can come on, dude, I'm not ironing my crease. Okay, yeah, that's fine. Or my seam, iron my seam. I like to do it, and I just guide. And I actually put a lot of little patience and time into doing my blues, because it's so important. If you get up there and you're doing an award, either getting it or just there at award ceremony, and your uniform looks like crap, dude, I have no respect for you. Okay. It's like you get one opportunity, one time. You need to look good for whoever's up there getting some kind of life-changing, award that's going to be on their DD form, 214 for their whole life, and you look like a trash bag. Man, I'm not picking you for anything cool. All right. So now we got to care about on the left side for men, right side for women, is that now that the buttons have that seam in it, that kind of overlap. And so I always just kind of run my fingers through it. Just want to feel the back end, Just really nice. All right. I just kind of come in and just give a little bit of love. Remember that kind of 3D effect there. Make it look really nice. Just that 3D is just so nice. Okay. So I'll kind of just fast forward. Just make sure you go work that. All right. I don't want to waste your time with doing the things I'm already telling you. Okay, so see this? This is terrible. I make sure I have like triple the amount of starch on those. That's why I actually look like that. And then what you have to do is sort of just give yourself a signal, kind of like a guide on how to iron these things. When you take and you unbutton it, okay. So now what we're gonna do is we're just gonna unbutton the whole thing, okay? And this is what you should do until you get to like you're a pro, and this is what you certainly should do with your executive pair, okay? If you just have your utility one that you gotta wear every day because you're out there, oh God. God save you. You got the Pentagon. Okay. You can just leave it, buttoned, and just kind of hit it real quick, and you'll be okay. All right. But unbutton it. If you're more of a novice and you just like really crush this thing, man. This is like five times as thick. I tell you what, your whole uniform can look amazing if your collar looks ridiculous. No one's gonna pay attention. No one's gonna pay attention to anything else. Okay. And you know what? Some of this is gonna be hidden with your tie, so if you're a dude in particular. Tell you, I trashed these iron boards like. Oh, I have not done this in this uniform. You can glue these down. It's risky. Okay. The reason I didn't do this is sometimes the glue has a slight discoloration to it on the other side, and it ruins the entire uniform. So do not iron that or glue that down if you don't know what you're doing. I've always used Stitch Witch, and Stitch Witch will discolor it. So for me, I view it a little bit unnecessary, unless you want to have your executive pair be the one you wear, like your service dress coat, and no one's going to see it, but you just want something that's absolutely perfect. You can totally do that. You can also do that in your civilian, long sleeve shirts, especially when you retire or step early or whatever and go in the civilian sector. You can do all these tricks and you'll be so ahead of everybody else because they won't have any of these skills or experience, or they won't have the foreskin. Okay, first let's talk about your executive. Look, this is an old school trick. See the cuff here? See the thick seam and the thin seam? Take a thread, a needle, and thread some string through there, and on the very top hole, you thread that together so that when the cuff is extended, you have a permanent crease guide. So crease guide, and it looks great, unbelievably great. You can even do it on this side too. So it has this, I mean, you got to get as close together as possible. I don't have the patience to do a video on that, but it will be the most unbelievably awesome thing you will ever do to your uniforms is create crease guides in them. We'll do it right up here too. I don't think you can do it up there, but do it right here. This one's the most important one, so let's right, and then what you want, some uniforms will be challenging. I'll tell you, this one's very poorly made. The crap I got on base, it's trash and just how it is. So it was not possible for me to get my crease to go to my cuff. It's just trash. So it's going all the way through the back. And I don't particularly enjoy that, but what I do is I just end it at the cuff right there. And this is under my service dress anyway. So this is with in case like I'm at a convention or whatever, we go out to eat and I take the coat off and I just don't want to look I want to look super sharp even with the coat off. So that's why I iron this thing really nicely for that occasion. So all right, your day-to-day ones you can iron on the inside, okay, just like this. I'll show you. Having a significant other or a friend help you is pretty good. You can do each other's uniforms together. But you'll see, you still have this kind of like wavy thing. The tie will, of course, get rid of that. But ironing from the inside will save the lifespan of your uniform. And I will tell you, I went to basic training in 1999, and I have my original blues top in my closet still, because I've taken care of it because I want to retire in it. So I will retire in the blues that I was issued in 1999, and it's currently 2024, and I'm going to retire in a few months. And I don't think I've ever heard anybody able to do that, especially because they get fat and yeah, it's just how it is. So all right, that's it for the top. All right. Bottoms, check it out, people. Same deal. All right. The first huge deal is that these will fade, and they'll fade very quick, and they can fade on the first session. If you iron this on high with steam on the outside, it's going to discolor. You don't have any option to iron this on the inside. You just don't. Okay. So to be very smart on what you do. Now, you'll have this kind of like steam picture usually on most irons. And what I do is I put it right at the intersection of the first image of the steam. So it's right below steam temperature, but it's right at there. And you don't need a lot of pressure to do this. This is really important, okay? The seam here will discolor. It will actually lighten up because there's a flap in there that they, I'll show you. I just wish our uniforms were better. Look at this. I don't know why they do this. So you have this seam where they have like this cross stitching on one side, both two sides, and an overlap. So as you iron, you're pushing into that second piece of fabric, and it starts to make the seam shine, shiny. So dumb the way that's done, but you just gotta live with it, okay? Unless you get custom apparel, which I've thought about, but whatever. I don't wear my blues that often, so. So for this, you want to make sure it's nice and cool. If that steam's coming out, you got to cool it down a little bit. Okay. And so what you do is you just push. Okay. And you can come in and you can see, look, with this color, it'll make the iron imprint on this thing. If it begins to shine like that, you know that it's too hot. Okay. And you can actually take a face cloth and wipe that, and that shine will come off. You can see, watch. Like this, the shine comes off. So then you know it's too hot that way. And if water boils off the top of that thing, it's too hot. Okay. So also you can just kind of just do the edge here and push on there. And if you've done this a bunch of times, I mean, I thoroughly washed this thing and my crease is still there. So all I'm just doing is just kind of lifting it off of itself, so it kind of sticks out as I'm walking around. Okay, so remember on when you're coming up on the pocket. Okay, let me see, flip it around. So when you're coming up on the pocket, you have to put your hand in and take that pocket back, because again, if you iron over the pocket, it's going to make this whole area shiny. Man, you just don't want that. Okay, these things are not cheap, and you want to look nice. Okay, the whole point here. So now I'm at a pretty good temperature because I don't hear anything boiling and it's not shiny. Okay, I intentionally did that to my uniform to show you guys that if you get a little bit of shininess when you put the iron down, it's too hot. Okay, now here's another travesty is that they're shipping these things pre-creased and the creases are trash. Okay. You should be going to the damn buckle, but the manufacturers have them go in random places. And you just, you know, if it's pre-seamed and you're kind of screwed, you just follow it. Okay. Now there is a way to get that seam out, but you have to do it earlier rather than later. If you've had this thing a couple of years and you've been ironing through that seam's never going to come out. If you just bought it and that pre-seam is going this way, you can get that out. Once you wash it, it should be gone. And you can even work it out with a face cloth and water. You can work that seam out and then go from the middle of the pant bottom all the way to the buckle. Okay, not over here. This is stupid. I don't know why they do this, but it should not go off. These were pre-seamed, and I think I dropped these off at the dry cleaners. I forget the story behind these particular ones, but likely everyone who's watching, you're screwed, and you just got to follow it, and you're gonna look worse than Air Force Camp. Just how it's gonna be. Okay, you're one of the people I'm gonna look better than. So you can go to the store, go to the X or whatever. Clothing sales, whatever it is, by the time you're watching this video, and get your uniform. And what you can do too is if they're on the shelf, like look at them. I'm telling you, each one is made by hand. I think it's by like the Lighthouse of the Blind, which is great, but they are blind, right? And they do a really good job of being pretty consistent, but they don't for someone who wants their uniform to be the best in the entire unit. You've got to make sure that you go through that rack and you pick the absolute best one. Think of it as Christmas tree shopping. All right. Yeah, they're saying the same DNA, all right, is growing in the same area, but how those trees look absolutely different is beyond me. So you got to go through with a fine-tooth comb and find out the threading and everything. Some of them I've seen where the damn buckle just came off after a couple months past the return period because people aren't even looking. So look at it, pull on things while you're at the store. Okay, make sure you get the best uniform that they have to offer. Okay, now the top here, you have the crappy wrinkles. Just pull, just kind of go like this and pull the seam. It just looks so much better. If you iron it, it's got to be on low temp because there's so much fabric overlay here, it'll start getting shiny. You can see a little bit of shininess. It'll come off once I wipe it with a rag, but you just want to be careful if you're kind of new to this. Just kind of stretch those seams and you'll look so much better. The same pocket too, just kind of stretch those seams and button the crap. Okay, don't put your wallet in here because you'll friggin' forget and you'll be that turd that's walking around with the junk not buttoned. Okay, if your uniform in your service has a button. So I always put my stuff in the inside coat pocket of my coat and only have my ID and like that's it. I don't bring a wallet. You want to look smooth and good. There's bulge either in your damn pocket back here and up there, whatever. You look like a tool. All right. If you want to be the one best in the unit, you got to have everything squared away. Okay. All right. So hopefully that's helpful. Some tricks. Okay. If you're traveling, you can take a big bag, one of those storage bags, put your uniform in the bag, keep some air in it. More air, less wrinkle. Put it in there, fold it in thirds, okay? And keep air in there so that if you bring it on the plane, it doesn't get compressed. God forbid it goes in your check-in luggage and it gets compressed on 40 other bags. That air keeps it from getting crushed. As soon as you get to the hotel, take it out, put it in the bathroom. Hang it up on the hanger and turn the hot water on and take a really long hot bath, a really long hot shower, or just let the shower run for a while. That water will come in and relax the threads. If you do not have access to the iron, that will do the job 80%. Okay. Gets almost all the wrinkles out. If you can iron while it's on the hanger, you can just hold the hanger with the steam and, oops, forgot. You can hold the uniform up on the hanger with the steam and steam the uniform and it will relax all of the wrinkles. If you can't get it in the bathroom and turn the hot water on, or you're morally opposed to running 40 gallons down the drain, then you can do that if you have an iron. Okay. If you don't have an iron, you gotta throw it in the shower and relax the wrinkles through the steam that's coming out of the shower. Okay. All right. Air Force Can, I wish I would have done that years ago for you guys, but hopefully it'll help the next generation.